So we're gonna get them nice and submissive. Pick up your sitting trot, and ideally you wanna just come up cantering. Good, so he's ready. Step into your inside stirrup, good. So now we have to bring him back, and then you're gonna think boot him up, boot him up, boot him up, boot him up, without letting him go faster. Little what I would call passive punishment, okay? Gonna go like quarter turn, canter off. Right, good bingo. That was a great bingo. Now this canter is way better than it was last week. So let's try to stay out of the puddles. And we're always thinking both hands inside, okay? Right, you gotta open your inside rein a little bit, Riley. Think about turning them from the outside rein. Okay, there. So when you, on the upward beat, see his mane flips up? Think sort of rock them back and lift them up. Rock them back and lift them up. There we go. So you see it brings his balance back to his haunches. There you go. Rock him. Come on, keep doing it. Don't let him just go around like a little quick pony. Yes. And now let's sit tall. Use your seat to trot. Stay sitting. Good, good. And let's walk using your seat. Outside rein, toes up. Not toes up, heels up. When I said rock him back and lift it up, did you feel his weight sort of shift to the hind end?
Yeah, I actually really felt that.
Thank God, okay? Because this is what we want him to do, okay? So we want to help him out a little bit. Now, probably in the past, if we did that, he would have broke. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're going to try to do this again. So that was an incredible canter depart too, even though the first one wasn't. But this is what we do. We train correctly. And the more we do that, the better stuff we get. So we never want him to run into the canter. Anytime he tries to run into the canter, bring him back, neutralize, poof, ask again. Okay? Anytime you're ready, a little outside rein, thinking both hands to the inside. Yes, open the inside rein. Don't overbend. A little quarter turn and canter off. All right, get him in the bridle. Half halt because he's just sort of running. There we go. Then quarter turn. Don't overbend him. All right, this is what we, as a matter of fact, what he needs is a counter bend, not an inside bend. All right, so easy, right? We don't want, yeah. We want a canter out of a good trot, not when you're fighting him. Little opening inside rein. Open the inside rein. Good. Right? So you're gonna think little quarter turn, like a square, and then you're gonna canter. Open the inside rein, yep, and canter. You wanna cast for the canter in the quarter turn. Right, bring him back. Put him into neutral, kick, kick, without him going faster. And, no, open the inside rein, and again. Good, he looked great, he looked great. You gotta be sharp and quick. Okay, nope, half halt, let's ask him to walk. Brrr. Walking active and sitting trot and immediately canter off. Good, okay, see? So we don't want to waste all that energy trotting around. So, is he on the outside rein? Can you lift him up and rock him back with your heel up? Lift him up and rock, yeah, there you go. Lift, okay, good, Grand Prix rider, right? So he's a little bit too deep. Get off the inside rein. Half, lift him up and rock him back. Bring your inside heel up. Look up over his ears, and he needs to lift up and rock back more. There, more. Yes, upward half halt with the, there. Upward half halt with the outside rein. Come on, bring him back, Riley. You got to do something. There, good, there. That's okay. Sit and walk. Don't waste all this energy running around. Sit and walk. Give him a big pet.